Hey everybody! Today I'm going to be talking about my favorite lenses for the Canon 5D Mark III. Hey, what's up? My name is Melissa Dale. I'm a photographer and video editor, and today I'm going to be talking about my top two lenses of the moment for portrait photography. So I've been transitioning from shooting more in a studio environment to more outdoors and just being inspired by nature and the landscape around me. And for shooting outdoors, this is definitely my favorite lens. It does give some amount of distortion to the face, but I actually find the distortion to be really flattering, specifically if you're shooting a few inches down on someone or a few inches up. It really makes your photos look really dramatic, and I really like that. I've also shot with this lens in every natural lighting situation, so golden hour, blue light, harsh sunlight, and I always love the results. As for the cons, I would say that if you don't like that distorted view it gives, you're not gonna like this lens if you're trying to make your portraits look more normal. I would also say that I tend to not use this lens in the studio. You could use it in the studio, but I just think for me, usually what people are wanting is more of a standard headshot from the waist up, and this is definitely not the lens for that. It's just too wide. But if you're someone who's into doing travel photography and more of that whole like style of like capturing the area around someone, I really, really recommend this lens. So a lot of people hate on this lens because it's the kit lens, which means it's the lens that comes with the camera. But I really love it. I find it extremely versatile, and I take it with me 100% of the time when I'm doing event photography. And although a lot of people prefer shooting with prime lenses for portraiture, I really found that I have taken some of my favorite portraits with this lens. The zoom capabilities on this is pretty amazing, and if you're someone who's interested in getting into video, this is the lens you have to get. The cons would be that it's not great for low lighting. It only opens up to f4. And if you're new to photography and you don't know what that means, I'll put a short description of aperture and f-stops in the description below. The other con is that it's heavy and it's a pain to carry around with you. But if you're a budding photographer, you're just gonna have to get used to carrying a ton of crap with you all the time. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and you're feeling inspired to go shoot. Until next week, you can stay connected with me on Instagram. Thanks for watching. Bye, babes.